Hi guys. So I have a Temu art supply haul. It's not just this, I have more around. And I thought I would first show you everything I got, and then I will be testing out all the supplies and letting you know what I thought of them. I'm just gonna get straight to it. So the first thing I have is this set of alcohol markers. And technically I got this for free. I wouldn't have bought it. Sorry about the shaky camera, by the way. I wouldn't have normally bought this because I use Copics, but I got this for free because Temu has the sort of coupon discount thing where, like, I think you have to have purchased from them before you get this offer, but then if you get like 5 people to sign up for the app, you get like a free gift of your choice. So I just had friends sign up and then I chose these markers. One side is a chisel tip and the other is a bullet. I only use brush tip markers usually, but I figured, hey, if I can get it for free and there are a ton of colors, then I can always make use of them no matter what. They're touch yuch yuch markers. I don't know why they're called that, but yeah, I think I'm trying to remember how many colors there were. I think it was like 148 or there's something like that. And they came in this zipper case. So we'll be trying those out later. Next, I got this set of 6. I'm saying a lot. This is my late night. This is like middle of the night to me, so I apologize for that. Charcoal pencils. And I've never used charcoal pencils. I've only used like charcoal sticks and everything. But I thought these were really neat looking. Like they were just really pretty. And they range between soft, medium, and hard. So we'll see how that goes. Like I said, I've never sketched with a charcoal pencil before. I'm sure it's gonna be just as messy, but hopefully not. I got a watercolor pad. This is an A5, and there are 20 sheets in here. I doubt it's acid-free because I couldn't find anything saying it was, but they're actually pretty thick. Like it's good quality paper. And I just sketched this on it so that I can test out the paper later. I'm gonna do watercolor over this, which, in case anyone's curious, I use the Faber-Castell 8B9000 series pencils because you can use watercolor over them and they don't smear graphite around. So that I did not get from Temu, but I figured I would let you know because I use it in multiple things in this video. Next, I got this, which I have to say so far, I'm the most impressed with this item. This is a watercolor sketchbook. It's got a very nice cloth hardcover cover. It has a really good strap and a little strap to hold a pencil or something. It's small, like I chose the small size because I just wanted to try it out. It's got 20 sheets. It lies perfectly flat. I believe it has a pocket. Yeah, it has a pocket in the back. It's cold press and I'll be filling in this doodle. I'll be painting in this doodle in this video. And I swatched some of my homemade watercolors that I made myself. But the paper is really good quality feeling. It feels just like my Paul Rubens watercolor sketchbook that I have, which is my favorite thing to paint in. So I'm excited to try this out, the actual drawing. But I was so impressed with this. I'm gonna put the prices down in the description if I remember for everything, but I know for a fact this was under $6 and the quality is phenomenal. Like just from what I've, just the feeling of it and just even just doing this, like, the quality of this is amazing, and it was under $6. So I absolutely plan on buying more of these, like a handful of these. A little thing I just wanted to mention is I got my watercolor tins from Temu. I got like 4 of these and the magnets that I needed to put my handmade watercolors in. And yeah, they worked out great. So I just wanted to show that I got these on Temu also. Next is another sketchbook that I was very impressed with. I haven't used it yet, but I did that damage myself, so ignore that. But this is a strictly dry media sketchbook because the paper is thin, but I was really impressed by the cover, the soft cover, and it even has this foiling detail. And if you crack the spine, which I'm fine with, then it lies perfectly flat. So that was impressive already. Again, the paper's kind of thin, so you really can only use dry media in this. Like, it's not a coated paper either that will hold up against marker and stuff. I think that would shred this paper. So I would solely use dry media in this, but I did really, I don't know, I was impressed by this. So I actually want to buy a couple more of these also. Next, I got these brushes. These are bamboo watercolor brushes. I don't know if they're actually bamboo. They're very lightweight. The detail around the top, which I don't know if you'll be able to see, I can tell is wood. Well, I mean, you know what I mean? It has like a wood grain, so it's some sort of wood or possibly bamboo. I haven't used them yet, and it came as a set of 3, and they're each a different size. So I'll be washing the glue off of those that hold the bristles together and testing those out in the video. Next, I got this tiny little bottle of the color Dragon fountain pen ink from, I guess, Banmi is the company. I was expecting this bottle to be much bigger, which is just my fault. I didn't know how much 15 milliliters would be. But the color of this ink is actually really great, which I will show you in a bit. I did already test out the watercolors. The fountain pen inks, because I don't plan on drawing with them in this picture, in this video. I just wanted to show you what they look like. And then I also got this Ostrich black carbon ink, because my black carbon ink that I have of a different brand is in storage right now and I'm having trouble finding it. So I figured I would just replace it. And yeah, so I got that, which is a much bigger bottle. This is 60 milliliters, so I was much happier with that. I got this clear fountain pen. I got some ink in the cap, but let me take the cap off so I can show you. This is a transparent bodied fountain pen, and it's supposed to be a large capacity for ink. And I currently have the Dragon ink in this one. And then I got this fountain pen, which I have some Noodler's ink in. But I was shocked by this because this pen was $2. $2 and some change, and I've only used it once so far just to test it out to see if it works, and it did. So that's already shocking. It also feels really nice. It has a great weight to it and everything, but yeah, so I got both of those fountain pens. This is my Lamy, but I'm going to be showing you the Ostrich black ink, which is in it. And then I think this is the final object, and this is just a mechanical pencil. It's a 0.3. I figured I'd try it and see how it is for sketching. And I think it came with HB lead. And that's it. So let's get to the art making.
I can get to sleep. I think about the implications of diving in too deep. Possibly the complications, especially at night. I worry over situations. I know we'll be alright. Perhaps it's just imagination. Day after day it reappears. Night after night my heartbeat shows the fear. Ghosts appear and fade away. Alone between the sheets only brings exasperation. It's time to walk the streets. Smell the desperation. At least there's pretty lights. Though there's little variation, it nullifies the night from overkill. Day after day it reappears. Night after night my heartbeat shows the fear. Back another day.
Again, I'm gonna go ahead and test the touch markers, and I'm just gonna color in this little guy down here with them just to get an idea of how they work and if they match the caps well enough. But real quick, I did paint in this and I recorded it, but then when I went to save the recording, the file got messed up. So unfortunately, I don't have the video of me testing out this small watercolor sketchbook. However, as you can see, it worked out really well. There's like not really any warping to the paper. I'm trying to be careful because I've got wet paint here, but it's perfectly clear on the other side. It didn't bleed through, obviously. And yeah, it just worked really well. I'm really happy with this, and I still plan on buying a few more with different color covers and everything, because they had a plethora of cover options for this. So yeah, that one turned out well, but let's go ahead and try out the markers. I picked out the colors that look like they will be the right colors based on the caps. So hopefully they are once I start using them. And if not, then we know that at least the markers won't match the caps well. Oh, that matches really well. Okay, that's one of the like the cheaper markers. One of the downfalls is they just never match their caps, but this is exact to the cap, so again, it's gray though, so it's kind of an easy one to get right. We'll see once we move on to the actual colored markers. It's blending really nicely rather than giving me streaks, which is as expected because it's an alcohol marker, but you know, there's a lot of bleed, but that's to be expected from alcohol markers. Hopefully this brown isn't too dark. No, that's pretty accurate to the cap. It's a little darker than the cap, but not too much. Man, these ones really bleed. I think they bleed more than Copics do. Granted, I just haven't used alcohol markers in a while, so I'm trying to be careful. Oh wait, is his whole body dark brown? I think it is. Ooh, I should have looked at a reference while I did this. I think his whole body is this dark brown. It is now, for the sake of this. My dog is right beneath the camera, looking out the window, so I really hope no one walks by or she will start barking. Man, these are really juicy. It really spreads. Maybe if I'm gonna have to like, yeah, I'm getting like, I'm trying to get nowhere near the line art and it's still like bleeding past it. So that's the only thing to be aware of so far for these is it looks like you can't color in the lines. Even if you're being very careful. Should we try a little shading? I'm digging through the markers off camera. Maybe some pink shading, just to have fun with it. Oh, that's weird. The alcohol, like, it's like lightening it and making it spotted. Oh no, let me try something darker. I don't want anything like super, super dark, but I want something darker than that just so we can see. Let's try some blue shading. See, look at that though. It's like it removed the color. All right, the dark doesn't do that, the dark blue. Oh, I didn't color in his nose. Oh well. God, the bleeding is so bad on this. Yeah, so it bleeds and feathers a lot, but, and that light color did some weird things when I tried to use it to shade. Aside from that, though, the pros are there was definitely no streaking, and the colors are very accurate to the caps, which I wasn't expecting. Also, they're very juicy, which means they're not about to dry out right when you buy them. So that's good. Let me see if you can... There we go. I hope that was on camera this whole time. But yeah, that wasn't bad. Like, I'm surprised the lack of streaks. The lack of streaks is impressive. The feathering and bleeding, not so much, but everything else, that worked out really well. So those are good. I'm actually gifting these to the kid who lives next door because
He's like 12 and he is a budding artist, and I want to support children trying to get into the arts. I grew up very poor and I know what it's like to not be able to afford art supplies. So since I got these for free and I have Copics, I figured I would gift these to him. But they definitely, they work well for a knockoff. So thumbs up to those.
How it works, it feels a little worse than when we drove our hearse right through that screaming crowd while laughing up a storm until we were just bone, until it got so warm that none of us could sleep and all the styrofoam began to melt away. We tried to find some worms to eat in the decay, but none of them were home. Inside the catacomb, a million ancient bees began to sting our knees while we were on our knees praying that disease would leave the ones we love and never come again. On the radio we heard November rain, that solo's real long, but it's...
All right, so I ended up with full storage on my phone in the middle of recording that, so I lost the end of it again, but I didn't do too much. I just did a simple sort of wash over everything, but this is how it looks. Sadie, don't hit my tripod. this is how it looks. It did really well at not buckling and everything. I was worried that since it's just glued on one side instead of a full block, that I was going to get too much warping and it would make it difficult to paint, but that didn't happen. Granted, I wasn't doing like giant amounts of water, but still. Yeah, happy with how it turned out. I used my handmade watercolors, but this was good. So this watercolor pad, like I said, I don't think it's acid free, but everything else was great about it. I enjoyed using that and I'm going to use it more in the future, especially because I love the size. But that one was another good one. All right, so on to the final supplies. We have the Vincent van Gogh sketchbook that I got, the charcoal pencils, which I already pre-sharpened, and then the little mechanical pencil. Before I start, I did do a little more in here. I did this, just a little character doodle that I used a reference off Pinterest, and then some freeform eyes to practice with watercolor and gouache. And I did a wash on the back for a future painting, and it's still perfectly flat, the paper. There's no warping at all. And yeah, it's turning out great. This is still my favorite item from Temu, and I have a feeling it's going to stay that way, especially since I'm not crazy about charcoal pencils, which is what we're about to try out. And these are the last of the supplies. So definitely that watercolor sketchbook is my favorite item I got off Temu. But let's go ahead and mess around with these charcoal pencils. I apologize for any camera shaking that still might happen. My tripod's like leaning against my desk because it's the only way I can get the right angle. So sorry about that. But let's go ahead and just start messing about. These definitely feel kind of scratchy, and I don't know if that's the pencil or the sketchbook pad. Hopefully I'll know more once I try the mechanical pencil, because I'll be able to compare how that feels on this paper as opposed to the charcoal pencils. I'm doing this because I'm going to try using a blending stick, which is why I'm just doing sort of blobs of color right now. I've never like used blending sticks. I don't actually know how I'm going to feel about it or how it's going to go, but I definitely thought these would be blacker because they're charcoal, but I've never used charcoal pencils, so that could just be my mistake in thinking that. Let's see. They're definitely more gray, like almost like graphite, compared to what I thought they would be. That was the medium, by the way, because there's hard, soft, and medium. That was the medium, so that wasn't even the hardest. They don't blend that. I thought it would blend much easier. Again, this is all probably just because I've never used the supplies. I don't know what I'm doing. If you can't tell from how this is going. I definitely thought they would blend easier. Let me get the soft. Here we go. Let's see if the soft blends better. All Right, the soft one does blend a little better. It's still a bit stiff on the page, the charcoal itself, but oh man, this is why I don't use charcoal. I have no idea what I'm doing. This just looks like a sloppy mess. You'd think common sense would be enough, but apparently not. That is a horrible nose, but it's the best I think I'm gonna get with charcoal pencils. Yeah, I really thought these would be just blacker. The charcoal itself, I thought it would, let me see if I can just, see, look, look how black that is. That's the soft. This is the hard. Yeah, the hard's definitely grayer. And then this is the medium. Yeah, the harder ones definitely have the scratch, which makes sense, more than the soft one does. Let me see if I can get, I guess it's just I was pushing too light, because that's black. Yeah, I guess I was just pushing too light. I just didn't want to push too hard and make like a huge mess with the graphite. I mean the charcoal. I'm so anti-charcoal mess, I guess. But it does look like you can get a much blacker color if you are braver than I was being and just use the damn pencil the way you're supposed to. Actually push it against the paper. Yeah, that's definitely blacker. I mean, it's still not a good nose, but that's my fault. Let's see how the mechanical pencil does. Should I zoom in, by the way? Here, that's probably a better view for you. Let's see. Oh no! Well, that doesn't bode well. The graphite just snapped inside the pencil and came out. Let's see. Is that all that's in here? Hold on. No. Okay, I got some more. Oh, that's pencil. Oh, it snapped again. This is very lightweight graphite, it seems. I'm not a fan of how thin this is. Like, I like kind of blurrier, sketchier lines and softer lead that sort of glides better. And this is giving me just like super sharp, brittle lines. This is does not glide well on the paper. But that's due to the width of the lead, I think. That has nothing to do with the pencil itself. Like, the pencil's doing its job. It is giving me lead the way it's supposed to. And that's all I can really ask for. I just think this is a very fine lead, which is not what I'm used to using. So it's making things difficult. Man, even if I try to have a really light hand with it, I get very sharp lines with this. I don't know if it's solely the size of the lead or if it's just the lead they give you with this kind of sucks. Like, it's very hard and brittle. Very hard and brittle lead. Which obviously you could get your own lead elsewhere in the same size.
Yeah, I mean, it's a mechanical pencil. I didn't expect anything fabulous from it. I use the Bic, just the really cheap, simple Bic mechanical pencils, and I think they work great. I also use the cheap Bic, what are they called? Ballpoint pens, and I love them. So I would absolutely just use a Bic mechanical pencil over this. Sorry. Sorry, mechanical pencil, but not for me. I don't think any of those were for me, and it's not the fault of the art supplies. I don't think. It's difficult for me to say because I don't use those types of art supplies, but I don't think any of these are for me. Let me see if I can, what is this? Okay, this is the soft one. I don't like the texture of the sketchbook paper. I haven't commented on the sketchbook itself, but I think that's one of the things I'm having issue with. It's very textured, and it's weird because it doesn't look like it, but if you feel it, it kind of feels like a very fine sandpaper. And I like to let my art supplies glide on the paper much more than this is allowing. Which sucks because I was like, oh, I definitely am going to buy some more of these just because, like, the quality it felt like from the cover and all of that. I was just like, oh, I really like this. I'm going to get some more. And now that I've used it, I'm like, oh, I don't like this paper, like, at all. So I actually don't think I'm going to buy another one of these. That was the charcoal pencils and the mechanical pencil and the sketchbook. I will gather the items. Oh, wait. Should I test out the fountain pens? I wasn't really going to, but I guess I could for you. It would just be me doing some quick line art with them. I'll go ahead and get them, though, and I guess we can throw that in here. So I'll be right back. All right, so in this fountain pen, as you saw earlier, I have the, ooh, which one is in this? Oh, the Dragon ink, the Banh Mi Dragon ink. And then in my Safari, I have the Carbon Black ink from Ostrich, I think was what it was called. I did just sketch this blobby sort of sketch, so I knew what to doodle. And I did it with the mechanical pencil, and I will say that the super abrasive, like, sharp scratchiness of it is absolutely the pencil, not that sketchbook, which surprised me. It was where it was sort of digging into the page. It was not gliding well, even though this is my Lutschterm sketchbook, which is very smooth paper. So that was actually the mechanical pencil. That mechanical pencil just sucks. But yeah, let's just see how this goes. Oh, and as you also saw, I got this fountain pen off Temu also. This is just the transparent, large capacity fountain pen. And as you can see, this is just a sort of blobby doodle, but I figured it would give me something to test out the fountain pen and ink for. I'm drawing, okay, so I usually draw like at a severe angle for my hand, but I'm trying to keep it straight for you guys. Let me make sure you're on camera.
Yeah. I'm trying to keep it straight for you guys, but it's making it very, like, difficult. My angles are all off right now, and it's definitely a learning curve. I haven't used this mechanical pencil in days at this point, so it's not the best flow, but it's definitely not the worst either. I gave this guy some weird little mullet type of, like, three-level mullet. I don't know why, I just thought it would be kind of interesting and cute. This fountain pen is a little scratchy, which I'm not sure if I said before, because it's been days since I did my original video here. Yeah, I definitely wish it flowed a bit smoother. See, like it's a fine tip, which the super fine ones sometimes do that, but I definitely wish it had a better flow to it. Because when I do really, like, quick, sharp lines, I kind of lose some of that ink. It's not, like, a very nicely flowing line. Let me switch to my Safari, which has the carbon ink. And yes, I realize this is going to be a little weird because it's going to be green and then black all of a sudden, but we're just testing things out, so it's okay. Let's give him some super janky wings. Yeah, that's our weird little dude. Sorry, I know I'm shaking the camera, but I figured I would stand up and show you everything. I love the dragon ink. I don't know if the color's showing up, but it's a sort of, well, it's this blue-green. And I just think I need to put it in a higher-end fountain pen. So this one, like I said, it was really cheap. And it technically works, but it is a bit scratchy, so I would definitely put that ink in a nicer pen and save this cheap pen just for messing about, nothing, no nice drawings or anything like that. And the carbon ink is nice and very black, which is what I want out of my carbon ink. I haven't tried to see if it's waterproof yet, which I'm not going to do in this video, but I'm happy with the ink on its own. And let's go to my final thoughts on everything now. All right, very quick final thoughts on each of the items. Charcoal pencils, I was not a fan. I don't know if it was me or if it was the item itself, but not crazy about them. Can't say I'd recommend them. But that's just me. Watercolor pad. Absolutely recommend this watercolor pad. Am I zoomed in? I didn't mean to be. absolutely recommend this. I really liked using this. The fountain pens were scratchy. I don't recommend the fountain pens themselves. They will do in a pinch, especially I think I liked this one more. They'll do in a pinch, but you definitely get what you pay for with fountain pens. Mechanical pencil, I kinda hated this, not gonna lie. Was not a fan of this at all. Getting on to the things I did like, the alcohol markers, whoops, sorry. The alcohol markers, which I don't have with me anymore, I gave them to, I'm trying to find the page that I tested that out on. Is this even the right sketchbook? Yes, it is the right sketchbook. Hold on. I think you get what you pay for alcohol markers. And by that, I mean they work. And they weren't that streaky. The colors matched and everything. They bleed a lot. But I did try blending just like a chunk of color on a separate piece of paper, like on a different day, and because they're not brush tip, because they're bullet nibs, they don't blend together very well, but they would absolutely work if you just want to start using alcohol markers as a beginner and you don't want to shell out a ton of money. So I say they were okay. That's what my opinion of the touch markers were. The inks, I love both of them. I love the ostrich carbon. Oh, I have cat hair on me. Love the ostrich carbon black ink, and I loved the dragon ink from Banmi. I just wish this were a bigger bottle. I hope I'm on camera right now. I can't actually see my view screen. But I approved of both of those, and I think those ones were great. My favorite item was this. Let me stand up so I can make sure you're seeing things. My favorite item was this watercolor sketchbook, which I'm sure you gathered already from this video. I just absolutely love it, and I think it's great quality, especially for the price, which was under $6 when I bought this. So, absolutely love that. Absolutely buying more. And then last was this Van Gogh sketchbook. I was happy with it at first, and then after using it, I really just hate the texture of the paper. So I'm gonna say it's okay, but not something I would buy again. Also, as you can see, I totally forgot to test out those three bamboo brushes, and I just decided I wasn't gonna bother once I realized it was after I recorded everything else. And they're sort of like a finer tipped detail brush, and I don't have anything right now that I wanted to test that out on, so we're just gonna pretend I didn't haul those. Overall though, my thoughts are that if you're doing your thorough research on the items that you're trying to buy on Temu, you can find good art supplies. You can find great inks, great watercolor paper, and everything else. Oh, watercolor pad, those were all great. But there is a lot of stuff on Temu that I didn't buy while looking at art supplies because I could tell they were cheap and they weren't, you know, cheaply made and they weren't going to work well. So this is not me saying like, oh, all art supplies on Temu are fantastic, go buy them. Absolutely not. I did a lot of skimming through art supplies on Temu to pick out the ones that I picked out, and I still only loved half of them. So just do your research like any other thing, but you can find art supplies that you'll love on Temu if you're thorough. And that's my final opinion of it. My final opinion is that you should absolutely buy this watercolor sketchbook and inks. And that's it. Otherwise, be careful while shopping, but yeah, you can definitely find some cool stuff, as I keep saying. And that's it. Hopefully you enjoyed this. I know this was a little all over the place. I still have Corona, so I am very tired, and I did this over the course of like a week and a half, which means I kept forgetting what I've done and what I haven't done in the video already, and there was very little planning on my practice sketches and everything. And by very little, I mean there was no planning on any of it. So just bear with me while I'm sick with my current videos. I appreciate everyone watching. I love you guys, and I will see you again soon. Bye!